Dear student, hope you all are well, safe, and follow the lockdown protocol. This time is really precious for all of you because you get so much time for all of those activities which you're not able to do because of lack of time. Now you get time for studies as well. So, with continuation of topic, this video covers the second part of photosynthesis in which we discuss about Calvin cycle, some plant adaptation and factors affecting this process. Calvin cycle, also sometimes termed as dark reaction, but there is no concern of darkness for this cycle. Just light source are not directly involved in this cycle. The outcome of photosynthesis first are ATP and NADH. ATP and NADH both are involved in CO2 fixation through this cycle, and sugar is formed. This cycle runs in the stroma part of chloroplast. Now, this picture shows the detailed view of chloroplast cell. As we know, chloroplast is double layered membrane. So it is outer membrane, there is inner membrane, the inner membrane is space, these are the stromal part, the granum which have the thylakoid, and there these are the some space and known as the thylakoid space. Calvin cycle possesses three phases that are carbon fixation, reduction and regeneration. Carbon fixation utilizes incorporation of CO2. Reduction utilizes the energy molecules to form compound. Regeneration regenerates the molecule for another cycle. This slide shows the overview of Calvin cycle. Here we see that Calvin cycle utilizes a Rubisco enzyme with 3 CO2. 6 ATP and 6 NADPH in phase 1. In phase 2 produces a sugar and other organic compound. Phase 3 regeneration of RUBP in presence of 3 more ATP molecule. Now we come to the first phase, that is carbon fixation. We start with first phase of Calvin cycle. In this, firstly, one molecule of CO2 is binded with 5 carbon ribulose bisphosphate and converted into 6 carbon intermediate compound, which further split it into 2 molecule of 3 carbon 3 phosphoglycerate. So here 3 carbon molecule in the form of CO2 and 3 RUBP regenerates the 6 molecule of 2 phosphoglycerate. Reaction type is synthesis. Enzyme involved, that is the Rubisco, that is synthase enzyme. And there is a summary having one carbon dioxide and one RUBP form the 6 carbon salt intermediate. This 6 carbon salt intermediate split it into 3 carbon molecule, that is 3 phosphoglycerate, and overall there is regeneration of 6 molecule of 3 phosphoglycerate, that is 3 times. Rubisco is one of the most abundant enzyme on earth. It is half of the protein available in a leaf. Rubisco is ribulose 5-phosphate carboxylase. It is a large in structure but slow reacting enzyme. Now we come to the second phase of the Kalman cycle, that is reduction. It utilizes the 6 molecule of ATP and 6 molecule of NADPH. Firstly, the 3-phosphoglycerate is of first phase of 3-phosphoglycerate of first phase is converted into 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate by utilizing one ATP molecule, and then this 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate is converted into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate by converting NADPH into NAD+ and release of one inorganic phosphate. So in total here 6 ATP and 6 NADPH is utilized for 6 molecule of 3-phosphoglycerate. Energy utilization in Kalman cycle, it shows that 3-phosphoglycerate is converted into a 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate by utilizing 6 ATP molecule. So that is the ATP phosphorylation is 3 carbon molecule. Reaction type is phosphorylation. Enzyme is kinase, that is a 3-phosphoglycerate kinase for the synthesis of 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. Now another step of this reduction phase is there is a generation of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. There is this step involves the enzyme 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate dehydrogenase for synthesis of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So it is a redox type of reaction. Enzyme is dehydrogenase. Now regeneration. This is third phase of Kalman cycle. The incoming 6 molecule of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, 1 molecule of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is converted into sugar or glucose, and rest of the 5 molecule of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is involved in the regeneration of RUBP. Hence the resynthesis of initial molecule gives this phase name regeneration. So the other that 5-3 glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate continue in the cycle to help regenerate the starting substances. Now the regeneration, the step here utilizes the 3 ATP molecule, and there is a regeneration of RUBP for another cycle to be get run. Rubisco bisphosphate is enzyme. Rubisco bisphosphate synthase is enzyme involved in this process. Total number of carbon involved in overall process is 15. So total in this regeneration process, that is involvement of 15 carbon molecule, 5 molecule of 3 carbon glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and 3 molecule of 5 carbon RUBP in total may involve the RUBP synthesis. Now Kalman cycle limits of adaptation are photorespiration, adaptation to hot and arid conditions. Photorespiration adaptation is seen in case of C3 plants, whereas adaptation to hot and arid condition is seen in C4 and CAM plants. Now C3 plants. These are plants whose first carbon fixation product is 3 carbon, that is phosphoglycerate. So the described Kalman cycle is mostly run in C3 plants. So here it is a 3 carbon phosphoglycerate molecule, which is very commonly seen in the case of normal Kalman cycle, as we discussed already. C3 plants. So if you see the structure of leaf in the case of C3 plants, stomata are open during the day. That is a mandatory condition for the C3 plants their stomata should be get open during the daytime and closed at night. Now, what happens to stomata in hot and arid condition in these C3 plants? The answer is, so we see that different types of the stomata opens and the closed. Now, in hot and arid condition, plant close the stomata to prevent water loss. So, as in above slide, the question is get asked about what happens to the stomata in hot and arid condition. So, in this hot and arid condition, mostly the stomata are remain closed and it prevent the water loss. Now, what effect does that have on CO2 and oxygen concentration? So, now we see that closed stomata, CO2 concentration decreases. That means in decreased CO2 concentration, stomatas are closed and stop Calvin cycle. Whereas in the increased oxygen concentration, Rudisco bind to oxygen, skip the Calvin cycle, and glucose is not produced. Now, there is a comparison slide between the carbon fixation and photorespiration process. Rubisco enzymes have two substrates, that is CO2 and oxygen. When CO2 binds to Rubisco, it yields two molecules of 2-phosphoglycerate. But when oxygen binds, it yields phosphoglycerate and 3-phosphoglycolate. CO2 binding to Rubisco is known as Calvin cycle, but oxygen binding is known as photorespiration. Now, this picture shows the reaction of ribulose bisphosphate with CO2 and the oxygen in presence of carboxylase or oxygenase enzyme and the products formed with the reaction. So the CO2 is get binded and there is a 3-phosphoglycerate and 3-phosphoglycerate is get formed when the oxygen is get binded. Then there is a formation of phosphoglycolate and the 3-phosphoglycerate. Phosphoglycolate, if that is get formed during the binding of oxygen with Rubisco. In photorespiration, the formation of phosphoglycolate is wasteful loss of carbon. Because it is not converted into sugar, that is why it is known as a wasteful loss, because it's not converted into sugar. To use this carbon from phosphoglycolate plant must use energy expensive process called photorespiration. So for utilization of this phosphoglycolate for some energy generation or some food production process, there is some energy expensive process goes on that is known as photorespiration. Now we come to the next slide, there is a photorespiration. So photo means in presence of light. Respiration means it consumes oxygen. This process wastes energy and reducing power, which result in production of ROS like H2O2 in peroxisomes. In photorespiration, there is no organic molecule is generated and also no generation of ATP. Now, if there is no role of photorespiration, then why it exists? Answer for this question we see in two way, first as a evolutionary baggage and in modern times. During evolution, atmospheric oxygen is less and CO2 is high, so it is just a metabolic relic, and also Rubisco inability to exclude oxygen that has a little input on photosynthesis. But now in modern times, Rubisco affinity to oxygen, so the negative impact on crop field. Now next slide, so the picture of some C3 plants. So these crops are rice, wheat, soya. Mostly hot, arid, dry condition are detrimental into C3 plants. In modern time, when oxygen concentration in atmosphere is 500 times higher than CO2, yet the Rubisco fixes 4 times more carbon dioxide in comparison to on oxygen. Now we see some photosynthetic adaptation. Two other photosynthetic adaptation is seen in plants during hot and arid condition. The two main are C4 plants that are having the spatial means structural separation, and CAM plants that are having the temporal or behavioral separations. Now there is an enzyme PP carboxylase that is the main enzyme for C4 plants having high affinity for CO2 and fixes CO2 when oxygen concentration is still high. The reaction carried by these enzymes are as such. So phosphoenolpyruvate is binding with the CO2, is converted into oxaloacetate. Oxaloacetate is get converted into malate. Malate is converted into a pyruvate. And this is how the 3 carbon molecule is further generated. The release of CO2 is further get utilized in the Calvin cycle. Pyruvate is get converted into a phosphoenolpyruvate as well. And now it is responsible for the binding of incoming CO2. So in C4 plants, the Calvin cycle with alternate mode of carbon fixation, in the case of C4 plant, so the Calvin cycle is alternate mode of carbon and produces a 4 carbon compound as a first organic component, and agriculture C4 crops are the sugar cane and corn. So this is structure, so the leaf of C4 plant. Leaf structure of C4 plant shows that bundle sheaths are tightly packed around vascular bundle, and mesophyll cells are loosely arranged near the leaf surface. So here is we see that the mesophyll cells, and these are vascular tissues, the bundle sheaths, which are a tightly packed structure. Now in C4 plant cycle run in two part. First part is of cycle runs in mesophyll, and the second part of cycle is run in bundle seed that generate a sugar to vascular tissue. Now mesophyll cells having PEP carboxylase enzyme which bind the incoming CO2 to 3 carbon phosphoenol pyruvate and convert it into a 4 carbon oxaloacetate. With the oxaloacetate is now converted into a malate with the help of enzyme malate dehydrogenase, and this malate is get entered inside the bundle sheath. Now the 4 carbon malate is exported in bundle sheath and get converted into 3 carbon pyruvate and CO2. The released CO2 is incorporated in Calvin cycle. Pyruvate is returned back to mesophyll cell, converted into a PEP by utilizing one molecule of ATP. Here we see the mesophyll cell act as a CO2 pump that is responsible for keeping the concentration of CO2 in bundle sheath high. So the CO2 concentration is get pumped by the mesophyll cell. Now the incoming CO2 is get entered inside the CO2 bundle sheath and now involved in the Calvin cycle for the sugar generation. Now this is just a total overview of this C4 cycle. Now we see that it is the leaf part, leaf that stomata are get opened, the CO2 is get entered. So mesophyll cell that is involved in the conversion of this CO2 into a malate. The malate is get entered inside the bundle sheath and this bundle sheath is run the Calvin cycle. Now the sugar is formed and get entered inside the vascular bundle. So we see that in complete description, the CO2 diffuses into mesophyll cell from the nearby stroma. So that you can see that in chloroplast, that mesophyll cell having the chloroplast that are responsible for the binding of CO2 and converting into a oxaloacetate. Now this chloroplast move that malate and that malate is further get entered inside the chloroplast of bundle sheath, where the CO2 is get entered inside the Calvin cycle and the released pyruvate is get further converted into a PEP. And this Calvin cycle is produces sugar which is get transported into vascular tissues. Now come to the next adaptation, that is a CAM plant, that is crassulacean acid metabolism or succulent plants, mostly the cacti and pineapples. In this plant, at night time, stomata opens, allow the entry of CO2 and added it to PEP. Carboxylase to form 4-carbon oxaloacetate, further converted to malate and then stored in vacuole of mesophyll cell. So if we have a comparison between the C4 and CAM plants, then we find out that in the case of C4 plant, malate after the formation is directly get entered inside the bundle sheath where it is get involved in the Calvin cycle. Whereas in the case of CAM plant, the malate formed is converted into a malic acid and get stored in the vacuole of chloroplast. Now, in daytime, in CAM plant, stomata remain closed, conserve water, no CO2 uptake goes on. Only the light reaction goes on, which help in the formation of ATP and NADPH. CO2 in organic acid is stored in the vacuoles from the night is released to run the Calvin cycle. So that is already stored CO2, which is in the form of malic acid, is now converted into a malate, and this malate is get entered inside the chloroplast where it is get involved in the that formation of CO2, that CO2 is released, CO2 is get binded with the Calvin cycle and the pyruvate is converted into a starch, and now that is how that in the CAM plant is get adapted. So here we see that CO2 in the day and night conditions, in the night CO2 uptake and fixation goes on, atmospheric CO2 that stomata is get open, atmospheric CO2 comes in, and ultimately that PEP with get binded to PEP carboxylase and that oxaloacetate is get formed. Oxaloacetate forms the malate. Malate is converted into a malic acid in stodia. And in the daytime, what happens? Decarboxylation of stored malate and relaxation of internal CO2. So the stomata get closed, so malic acid which is stored in vacuole is converted into malate. Malate comes into the chloroplast where it is get converted into CO2 and pyruvate, and CO2 is get entered inside the Calvin cycle and involved in the that glucose formation or the sugar formation. So night time CO2 is incorporated into organic acid like malate and malic acid, stored in vacuole, and in daytime malic acid converted to malate, then malate release CO2 and release CO2 into inside the into Calvin cycle for sugar formation. Also in daytime it produces energy for light reaction. Now it is a comparison between the C4 and CAM plant. So C4 plants show the spatial separation and CAM plants show the temporal separations. So we see that the mesophyll cell and the bundle seed. So you can see that in the C4 plant in the daytime that CO2 is comes in and get binded with PP, and there is a generation of oxaloacetate and then convert malate, and malate is get entered inside the bundle seed where the it releases CO2 and enter inside the Calvin cycle. In the case of that CAM plant in the night time, that CO2 is get entered inside the mesophyll cell, and mesophyll cell involved in the generation of malate and malic acid. Malic acid is stored in the vacuole, and in the daytime that malate is come inside the bundle seed where it may go for the Calvin cycle. So here the spatial separation is goes on and the temporal separation is occur in the case of CAM plant. Now the factors affecting the photosynthesis are light intensity, carbon dioxide and temperature. First factor is light intensity. So we see that low mid intensity, in the low mid intensity of light we get the linear response. As the light intensities get higher, the saturation is came and limit factor in photosynthesis. Higher intensity involve the generation of photorespiration, as already we discussed about it. Light compensation point, minimum light intensity at which the leaves show a net gain of carbon. Now the rate of photosynthesis is saturated as the CO2 and temperature level is increased. So for the rate of increase of photosynthesis, both of these two factors are equally responsible. So light intensity and CO2 whenever get increased, then the saturation level is get achieved. Now the another factor is CO2 concentration. In low CO2 concentration, the diffusion rate is limited. In high CO2 concentration, saturation is achieved with other limiting factor like light. So as discussed in light intensity, the rate of photosynthesis is saturated with increased CO2 and light concentration. The third factor is temperature. Plants having the optimum temperature range in which rate of photosynthesis increased. Graphs show the different temperature zone and optimal temperature for increased rate of photosynthesis. So we have a different temperature zone like Antarctic zone, cool coastal, evergreen areas and the summer conditions. So in these all conditions, there are different temperature range are there, like in an Antarctic condition with the temperature range is minus 5 to 20. That is the so here in this we see that the maximum rate of photosynthesis goes when we have a temperature of 5 to 10 degrees centigrade. Similarly, in the cool coastal areas, we have got the temperature range of 10 to 35 degree. In evergreen, we get the temperature range of 15 to 40 degree. And in the summers, we have got the huge intensity of temperatures. So already that in the high or hot arid condition, the stomatas are get closed to prevent the water loss. Increased CO2 level increases the maximum rate of photosynthesis. That is what we see in all the case of factors which are affecting the rate of photosynthesis. Now this is a comparison chart between all the factors, the light intensity, CO2 and temperature. Mostly light intensity affect the light reaction, increases the plateau since Calvin cycle cannot keep up with the light reaction. There is no directly involvement of Calvin cycle with the light reaction. Calvin cycle CO2 level increase to a plateau since light reaction cannot keep up with the Calvin cycle. So mostly that it is the CO2 level may be responsible for the increase of Kelvin cycle, but both of these two are interdependent because to run the Kelvin cycle, we require the ATP and NADPH, which is already get formed in the case of light reaction, and that both of these two components are get involved in the Kelvin cycle to run. Temperature maximum rate can be increased by increasing CO2. So that's all. Thank you for your patience. We see next slide for the some more few topics. Thank you.